In the earlier session we discussed how to convert, if you have given any rational number, how do you convert that rational number in the decimal form, and we have discussed if you have given a decimal number, how do you convert in the form of the fraction. Now based on that concept, let us solve exercise 1.3. Now see the first question. Here express each of the following decimal in the p by q form. Here they have given decimals, you have to write the decimals in the form of the fraction. Now here the first question, 0.57. So what we have discussed earlier, just write the number in what is there, 57, and after that you need to count after the decimal number how many numbers are there. Here after the decimal point how many numbers are there? 2 numbers are there. So in the denominator you need to keep 2 zeros. Like this you have to write. So what is the first one? Just you have to write the number. And after that, in the denominator, you have to write as many zeros. If you want to check, after that, you need to check after the decimal point how many numbers are there. Now, see the next question. 0.176. Similarly, write the number 176. And after that, how many numbers are there after the decimal point? 1, 2, 3. Here, keep 3 zeros. Now, see one more problem. Third one, 1.00001. So write the number. What's the number given? You have to write this one also, 1.00001. And write and count how many numbers are there after the decimal point. How many numbers are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So you need to keep here 5 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And one more problem is there, you can do it in the same way. Now see the second question. In the first question they have given a terminating decimal, and in the second question you can observe that they are giving a non-terminating repeating decimal. So in the earlier session we discussed how to solve this one by some process. What is that process? Just you need to check the periodicity of the given non-terminating repeating decimal, and you have to multiply with 10 or 100 by checking the periodicity, and after that you need to subtract the equations. This is the process. Solve the first one, 0.9 bar. This is the first one they have given. So let us take that value as x. So x is equal to 0.9 bar. That means which number is repeating here? 9. So write it as 0.999 and so on. Here you need to check the periodicity. What is meant by periodicity? How many numbers are repeating? That we call it as a periodicity. Here how many numbers are repeating? Only one number is repeating, which is 9. So here the periodicity is 1. So write it here. Since the periodicity is 1, let us take this one as equation 1. So multiply, which number you need to multiply here? You need to multiply with 10. If the periodicity is 2, you have to multiply with 100, like that. So multiply equation 1 with 10. So if you multiply with 10, what you get here? 10 into x, which is 10x. Here this number we are multiplying with 10. If you are multiplying with 10, what we have discussed, you need to move one number to the right. So here if you move one number to the right, what will come here? This number will come in here, 9 point, these numbers will be left out, 9, 9, 9, and so on. What is the next step? You need to subtract these two equations. So here call this one as equation 2. Now subtract 1 and 2. If you subtract, what will you get here? What are those equations we got here? 10x is equal to 9.999 and so on. And what is the first equation we got? X is equal to 0.999 and so on. If you are subtracting this one, what will you get? 10x minus x, which is nothing but 9x. Now subtract these two. 9 minus 9, 0. 9 minus 9, 0. 9 minus 9 0, and 9 minus 0 which is 9. You know that 9.0 is nothing but 9. So we got it here. 9x is equal to 9. Here what we are doing here, we are doing the multiplication. If this multiplication, if you take to the right hand side, it will become division. So we get x is equal to 9 by 9. This 9, this 9 will get cancelled. You will get the value of x as 1. So like this you need to solve. Now see the next question. By which number you need to multiply? You need to multiply with 100. So multiply 100 on both sides. If you multiply with 100 on both sides, what you will get here? 100 into x, which is nothing but 100x. Since here this number you need to multiply with 100, so two numbers you need to move to the right. So here you need to move these two numbers to the right. So what you get here? 57 point. If you move these two numbers, these are the numbers left out. Write it here. 57, 57, and so on. And what is the next step? You need to subtract these two equations. So write it here. X is equal to, what is the value of this one? 0.5757, and so on. Now subtract it. So what is the value of 100x minus 6? You know that if nothing is there, means 1 will be there. So what is the value of 100 minus 1, which is 99? So you get here 99x. Now this one you need to subtract. 7 minus 7, 0. This one 0, this 0, 0. And 57 minus 0, which is nothing but 57. Now here what we got it here? 99x is equal to 57. So what is the value of x here? 57 by 99. Like that you need to solve the problem. Just you need to check the periodicity and you have to multiply. Now two questions are there. You can do it in the same way. Now see the third question. What is the third question given? Find x plus y divided by x minus y. You need to solve this one, and they have given the value of x and they have given the value of y. What is the value of x given? 5 by 2. And what is the value of y given? Minus 3 by 4. Just putting the value of x and y, you need to find x plus y divided by x minus y. There is one more problem given, you can do it in the same way. Now see first this one. What we need to do here? First you need to calculate the value of x plus y. And after that you have to calculate the value of x minus y. You will get one answer for x plus y and you will get one more result for x minus y. And after that what we need to do? We need to divide those two numbers. So what is the first step? First you need to find the value of x plus y. So find it, x plus y. So what is the value of x they have given? 5 by 2 plus, what is the value of y? Minus 3 by 4. Now you need to solve this one. 5 by 2, what is the value of plus into minus? Minus 3 by 4. Now take the LCM of 2 and 4. You know that the LCM of 2 and 4 is 4. So write it here, is equal to 4. If you don't know how to find the LCM of 2 and 4, let's see. 2, 4. Here you know that 2 1's 2 and 2 2's 4. Again, in which table you will get 2? equal to, which is 4. Like this, you have to find the LCM of the given two numbers. So here, you got the LCM as 4. Now here, 2 is there, and there the denominator is 4. Now which number you need to multiply here, so that you will get the denominator as 4. So here you know that 2 into 2 is 4. Now here the denominator is 4. Here also the denominator is 4. So which number you have to multiply here? 2. For this, you have to multiply to the numerator also, since we are multiplying with the denominator. So here 5 into 2, which is 10. Here 4 is there, there also 4 is there. So just write the numerator. So what you will get here? 7 by 4. What is this one? X plus y. This is the value of x plus y. Now this what we have to calculate? X minus y. Now calculate x minus y. What is the value of x here? 5 by 2 minus, what is the value of y? Minus 3 by 4. The same thing, 5 by 2 minus into minus, which is plus 3 by 4. Just now we calculated the LCM of 2 and 4, which is 4. Which number you need to multiply? 2. Since you are multiplying, here also we have to multiply with 2. 5 to 10 plus 3, which is 13 by 4. This is the value of x minus y. So we got the value of x plus y and we got the value of x minus y. So what is the first step? They asked to find the value of x plus y divided by x minus y, and they have given the value of x as 5 by 2 and y as minus 3 by 4. Just you need to substitute the value of x and y in this expression and you have to find the value. So first we have calculated the value of x plus y and we have calculated the value of x minus y. Now just you need to divide those two values. So write it here. What we have to find? X plus y divided by x minus y. This you have to found. Now we calculated the value of x plus y. We got it as 7 by 4 divided by, we also find the value of x minus y, which is 13 by 4. Write it here, 13 by 4. So 7 by 4 into, here division is there, here I have written multiplication. If I change the symbol, what I need to do? I need to write the reciprocal of this number. What is the reciprocal of the number? Just you need to change the numerator as denominator and the denominator as the numerator. That means 13 by 4, you can write it as 4 by 13. If I have the multiplication. Since here division is there, we have changed it into the multiplication. For that reason, we change, we have written the reciprocal of this number. So here, this 4 will get cancelled. You will get 7 by 13. This is the value of x plus y divided by x minus y. Like that, you can do the second question also. Similarly, like this. Now, see the fourth question. What is the fourth question given? Divide the sum of minus 13 by 5 and 12 by 7 by the product of 1 by 2. This is the question they have given here. You need to solve this question. So here, what is the question given? Divide the sum of minus 13 by 5 and 12 by 7 and by the product of minus 13 by 7 and minus 1 by 2. Read the question. What they have given here? You need to divide this number and this number. Right? And they have given, before doing the division of these two numbers, what we need to do? You need to take the sum of these two numbers. First you need to take the sum of these two numbers. That means minus 13 by 5 plus 12 by 7. This you need to do. And after that, what they have given? by the product of, and product is nothing but the multiplication. So you need to multiply these two numbers. So that means minus 13 by 7 into minus 1 by 2. So what we have to do? We have to sum off. First you need to sum, and after that you need to multiply these two, and after getting the answer you need to divide these two values. This is the meaning of this question. So what they have told? Divide the sum of minus 13 by 5 and 12 by 7. That means you need to divide these two numbers. But before doing the division, you need to add this one and you need to multiply this one, and after that you need to divide the result of the answer. So do that one. So what is first, what we have to do? Sum of minus 13 by 5 and 12 by 7. You need to take the sum of these two values, which is nothing but minus 13 by 5 and 12 by 7. What is the LCM of 5 and 7? Since they are the prime numbers, just you need to take the multiplication. What you get? 75 is 35. So here multiply these two. What is the value of 13 into 7? And you know that 13 into 7 is nothing but 91. And after that, what is the value of 12 plus 5? Which is 60. Here, and after that, here minus is there, here plus is there. If one is minus and the other is plus, what we need to do? We need to subtract. What is the value of 91 minus 60? You can do it. What is the value of 91 minus 60? Which is nothing but 1 minus 0, which is 1. 9 minus 6, which is 3. Here, for the bigger number, which symbol is there? Minus is there. So here, for the answer also, we have to get the minus symbol. So what we are getting here? Minus 31 by 35. This is the value of sum of these two values. How do you find? Just you have to take the LCM of 5 and 7. You know that the LCM of 5 and 7 is 35. And after that, just cross multiply the value, you will get the answer. Now, you need to take the product of these two values, right? The product of which numbers? Minus 13 by 7 and minus 1 by 2. You need to take the product. That means you need to multiply those two values. Minus 13 by 7 into minus 1 by 2. You know that minus into minus is plus. And after that, if you want to multiply two fractions, just multiply the numerator and just multiply the denominator. So, what is the value of 13 into 1? Which is 13. And after that, what is the value of 7 into 2? Which is 14. Now, we have calculated the addition of these two numbers and the multiplication of these two numbers. So, according to the question, what we need to do? We need to divide these two values. So, here, right here, according to the problem, what we need to do? Just we need to take the division of these two values, which is minus 31 by 35 divided by 13 by 14. So again, the same thing, which is minus 31 by 35. Here, division is there. I have written the multiplication. So what we need to do? Just we need to take the reciprocal of this number. What is the reciprocal of 13 by 14? Which is 14 by 13. Now, you need to calculate this one. Now check it, is there any table will get cancelled here? Yes, here 7 to 14, 7 by the 35. Now multiply minus 31 with 2. What you will get here? 62. What is the value of 13 into 5? Which is 65. This is the value of this question. Just you need to take the sum and you need to take the product, and after that you need to divide. From this session is completed. In the next session, we are going to discuss the remaining problems.